So our first presenter today, he called me one day and I was, maybe he'll tell us the story. Michael, come on up here.
Let's give him a hand.
Yes.
You're not coming?
No, she's
no?
not coming.
Okay.
That's my wife back there.
Yes.
Please go and wave. There you go.
Here. Tell us, how did you and I connect?
I just called you and said, hey, I'm a passive investor. I have single family privileges? And you said, well, yeah, if you're a pig, and which is what it is. And then you asked me, well, so have you ever owned single family before? And I said, yeah, I got like 9 of them. And so we started talking.
And I said, you're doing it all the wrong way. Let me show you the right way to do it.
Which is partially true. I was making mistakes.
All right. So Michael here has a prior career in the military, and he was also a former professor. And his wife back there, who did not want to be up here, is a high school physics teacher. Oh, my goodness.
Yep.
All right. Oh, and you have a daughter who is not here.
I do have a daughter.
And she's in California?
Yes. She's a child psychologist. Well, there, she's like, I don't know, what was that, 2016, Shellanne? 2015, so how old was she then, like 18, 19?
All right.
But that was a Christmas trip, but she's now a child psychologist out in L.A.
Very good. Okay, so first of all, not why, but how did you find out about Lifestyles?
I'd been listening to Dell on the radio.
Okay.
For the most part, and I have a friend that I've known since childhood, and we are both former military, and he just came down to visit, and we're both swimmers. We were swimmers in high school together, and the topic of Dell came up because he was on the radio, and then Will said to me, well, hey, he said, do you know Lifestyles Unlimited? And I said, well, sort of. And he says, I'm a member. And all right, we started talking, and so I took the 2-hour whatever on the computer, and then I came down to a live event as soon as COVID was over.
All right, sounds good. So then your CPA said you needed to get...
Well, yeah, I had been talking to my CPA, because like I said, my wife works, she's a W-2 worker, but I'm not, and I was trying to decide, do I need to go back to work, or I didn't want to, and we had money, and I was talking to my accountant, and he said, you need to spend some money. And he said, or else you're gonna give it to the IRS. And I says, okay, what do you suggest? Because I had already rehabbed all my homes, and I couldn't really do anything. I had new roofs and other stuff like that. And he says, you don't need to do that much. He said, so why don't you go do some education stuff? And he says, since you are technically, officially, because I wasn't part of Lifestyles yet, he said, you are officially a real estate investor. He said, so go take some real estate classes and we can write it off. And so I came to the Lifestyles event. And
all right.
There you go.
Sounds good. Okay. So our house today is San Carlos Street.
Yeah, I love that house. It's a great house.
Okay. And how did you find out about this house?
Oh, from Justin. He's one of the Lifestyles Realtors.
Okay. And if you come this weekend, Chris here will tell us how you can connect with the Lifestyles Realty and how they can all help you and all they have to offer.
Oh, can you all actually hear me? Do I need to use the microphone?
You do need to use
the
microphone. The online folks.
For the online people.
Oh, it's for the online people. My apologies. Well, you know, I mean, I'm former military, so, you know, I can pull out that knife hand and yell and scream all day long.
All right, so you can see here the before and after. Did you put in a new roof?
No, we did not.
Okay, then you pressure wash the exterior and all that kind of good stuff.
Yeah, it was pressure washed and painted. I mean, not fancy paint because it's mostly vinyl siding, but yeah, the window shingles and the window trim and the soffit and yeah.
Okay.
So some painting.
All right, here's the before and after picture of the kitchen.
Yeah, that house was a mess. But I knew my contractor. I'd done this before myself, but I knew my contractor, and he and I scoped it and walked it, and we knew what we'd worked before, and we knew what to do, and we had everything all priced out, so we weren't scared.
Okay, so in his situation, he has some experience and he has his own contractor, but as you saw today or earlier this evening, there were a few of them up here that, you know, introduced themselves. So make sure you grab a card or get a hold of them and they will help you go through the process. Chris, again, will walk you through all this weekend.
Now, I just want to say one thing. I can promise you all, these contractors who are approved by Lifestyles, they know what they're doing. Now, I use my own contractor. But I have gone to many, many of these houses and several of the contractors you saw up here, I've worked with before. I mean, I didn't hire them, but I've gone and looked at houses and stuff. I make a practice of just going and checking the market out. I can tell you, these guys who are approved on the vendor list for Lifestyles, they really do know what they're doing.
Okay. He was not paid to say this, by the way.
No, I wasn't paid. I just was reaffirming that.
Yes.
I'm sorry.
Okay. So here's again a before and after, and this is your very standard, typical, you know, house that you have the before and after. It's gray. It's a click and lock on the floor. It's really not by your fifth house, all your houses should look all the same. There is really nothing exciting about the process except the numbers, right?
I call it the agreeable gray. It's the agreeable gray model.
That's it. All right. So let's talk about the numbers. You bought the house for $125,000, and you put in $66,250. With other closing costs, you came up to your equity capture is $45,000 because the after repair value is $255,000.
Yeah, it looks right to me.
The cash out of pocket is $24,000. Oh.
I kind of thought that, which is why I asked if I really needed to use this.
Thank you.
Okay, so the cash out of pocket, what he actually, well, there is a story to the $24,000, and can I go through it real quick?
Go for it.
Okay, so he called me. Well, we talked about this house, and it turns out that the house has a lot. It's the house and the lot next to it, and it all came as a package for $125,000. So what he did was sell the lot, and he pocketed $16,000, which brought his out-of-pocket down to $24,000. Okay? Yes, it's a very good deal. The cash flow is, the rent is $2,300, or $27,000 gross. After you pay the mortgage and the insurance and the tax, he's left with $558 a month, which is roughly about $6,700 a year, okay? So it is no different than putting $2,400,000 in the bank and making almost $6,700 at the end of 12 months. Okay, your cash on cash return is 27%, and your equity capture is 182%. Good?
That's great, man.
It is good.
What do you do with the cash flow?
We actually keep it in the bank. We have an account. We put it in there. We do not touch it. We do not rely on this. We'll buy something else.
Take that cash and roll it into your next, let it accumulate and roll it into
your next. Yes, correct.
Very good. Okay. So how has your life changed since joining Lifestyle?
I'm not making any mistakes. And we had rental properties, we had a bunch of them, but I made a lot of mistakes. And I did not understand how to properly take the tax write-offs. And I did not, there's just a lot of things I didn't understand. I mean, I was still making some money and everything else. I just wasn't maximizing things. And so now I spend a whole lot less time doing it. I don't freak out as much. And Shalane's a school teacher. And so we bought an RV. And so she's got holidays. She's got Christmas and all that stuff teachers normally have. So when it's time for a vacation, I don't have to coordinate with her, which is awesome. Like, we spent a month in Taos this Christmas. So she doesn't get out of work until Friday, like on the 23rd. So on Tuesday, I took off and started driving. Now, this is the interesting part because my 82-year-old mother lives with me, and she has dementia. Well, she has Alzheimer's, which is the advanced version of dementia. So she really needs hands-on care, and I'm not putting her into a nursing home. So Mom and I are up in the RV, and we cruise on out to Albuquerque. And I get there a day early and hang out in Albuquerque and go get myself some good carne asada and wait for Shalane to show up. And Shalane shows up. And I pick her up at the airport because I tow a car behind me. And we went to Taos. And so we spent 3 weeks in Taos.
So for all of those of you that have still a W-2 job, I want you to just picture yourself if you didn't have to go into the office and you had all the freedom in the world and the flexibility, which is what we're all looking for, right? You own your time and you do whatever you want. So I urge everyone who has not done anything, whether you're a member or not. So if you're not a member, you know what to do. You come this weekend. But if you are a member, I want you to ask yourself, if you don't have a house yet, why you don't have a house yet? Why haven't you done something already, you know, with all the education and everything that's available to you through Lifestyles? And I want you to call one of us, and we can help you get over whatever it is that is stopping you from moving forward.
And that, I'm going to say, is absolutely 100% true. The point is how did Lifestyles change for me? I don't freak out anymore.
He calls me.
Yeah, well, yeah, I have called Hind or I've texted her a few times. But, yeah, seriously, like, we had the freeze going on, okay? I wasn't back yet. I was on my way back. I was somewhere in the vicinity. I was somewhere in the vicinity of Lubbock on my way back, or Midland, or wherever I was. I'd already left Albuquerque. Charlene had already flown home, and the freeze was going on. And I wasn't worried because I had people I could call. I had people here in Houston. I got some houses in Beaumont. I got some houses up north in Cleveland, Conroe area. I got people. I just called them up. And I just says, hey, can you do me a favor? And I need you to go wrap the pipes, check this, do that, and all good. I wasn't worried about it, and I just got on the Zelle, and I sent them some money. You know, they go spend an hour or two doing something for me, and I sent them $60, and all good.
You know, for all those of you that think that being the landlord is really hard, and people call you at midnight, they call you about, you know, taxes, toilets, and what's the other T?
Tenants.
Yeah, your tenants call you and the toilets and all that. We had the freeze. I personally own 20 doors, and I really didn't go anywhere. I just copied and pasted the same text. So everybody's like, hey, you know what to do. Freeze is coming up. They're like, yep, we're good, we're good. And I never went to any house. I never wrapped any pipe because it's on them. And my friend said, are you not going to go? I said, no, I'm not going to go. They know what to do. And, you know, something happened, then I'll just deal with it. But if it's meant to happen, then it's going to happen. But they all know what to do. Okay, so you have your mentors, the Realty team. You use inspections by Pat for the inspection.
Yes, I use Pat.
Okay. Red Door Funding for your hard money lender, Capital Concepts for the conventional loan. And you have your own GC.
I do have my own GC, but Capital Concepts does it all. I've never actually, just so you know, I never talked to Red Door. Capital Concepts does everything for me.
Okay, they handled everything for you. Very good. So when you come this weekend again, Chris is going to talk to you about how, you know, you can get hold of all these vendors and how they can all help you move forward in your journey. Okay? I have one question for you.
Go for it.
What would you say to someone who's on the fence, here or online?
I mean, just I can just tell you from the heart.
Jump. Yes.
Do it. Because in the end, I'm not a young guy. I'm in my 50s. I'm almost 60. I got a wife who's 14 years younger than me. I got an 82-year-old mother. I got a 28-year-old daughter that swears to me that she's giving me a grandchild someday. And let's face it, I'm old. I'm fat. I got heart disease in my family. I could drop dead tomorrow. And Hin hates me to say that. But the fact of the matter is I'm not worried about it. My mom, my daughter, my wife, my grandchildren, they're good. No 401k, no pension system, none of that is going to make the difference. What it is I know when I die, they're getting a few million dollars in properties. And I don't have to worry about it.
Very good.
So do it. I don't care if you're 25 or if you're 65. Do it. Even one house will make the difference for you.
Absolutely. Okay. Any questions? Yes, ma'am. Oh, wait.
How many doors do you have now?
I own 11 now. I've sold a couple, yes, because I sold several, and then we did passive investing. He'll talk to you about passive investing, but we're invested in 4 apartments as passives as well. And we just get a quarterly check.
Okay. Any other?
I got a question online.
Yes.
How old was that house, and was it a 322 before renovations, or did you add?
It was a 1978 house, and it was a 4.2, and we turned it into a 5.3.
Okay. Anything else? Any other questions?
Any other questions in the room?
Last one.
Since I've joined Lifestyles, yes.
Your deal flow does come through Lifestyles Realty.
Yes. All right. Since I've joined Lifestyles, yes.
How hard is that to come by?
They send you out an email blast. If you like it, you tag it, and you'll explain all that, and they tell me if it's mine or not. I mean, you got Moon, you got Justin, and you got a few others. Moon and Justin's the only ones I worked with, but there's like 7 or 8 realtors, and every day I'm getting 10 different things. They say, you want it, and I look at it, and...
If it fits the box, yeah. If not...
If it fits my parameters, I tag it. And if it's mine, it's mine. If it's not, it's not. And Justin and Moon are awesome, and I'm sure the other realtors are good. It just has turned out I've gotten all my properties through Justin or Moon.
Okay, very good.
Awesome.
Okay.
Thank you for coming up and
thank you.
Back.
Thank you, Michael.
Great job.
Thanks.
Thank you,
guys. Michael.